So, a very good evening to all of you. There was some transmission error. Earlier, there was some transmission error. So, now the session has been started again. I hope now I am clearly audible and visible. So, this is your next Unacademy Combat, which is going to start. Going to be held on February 7th on coming Sunday at about 5 o'clock in the evening. So do attend the session where you will get questions from your medicine, pedia, psychiatry and derma. So there will be 45 MCQs from these four important subjects. Time duration will be 60 minutes in total. After the end of the quiz, you will get a detailed video solution of all the MCQs. So test yourself. Compete yourself and correct yourself with the help of video discussions. And regarding upcoming batch courses, these are your batch courses which are starting today itself on 4th of Feb, targeting your next 2022, which is in two slots. One is an evening batch, another one is a morning batch. So whatever suits you, you can join that batch course. Then there is a FMG 2021 batch course which is also starting today. So to avail the Unacademy Combat quiz session or to enroll for these batch courses, you need to subscribe yourself and you can apply this referral code at the time of checkout. And for the entire duration of subscription, you will be entitled to watch the recorded sessions also, so that you can revise the sessions at different levels of speed also. So without wasting further time, let us start with images part 1, where you will get some new images today. Like, I will put the question for you all. Like, this person is a public prosecutor who is sitting in the courtroom. Obviously, in the center head, we will have the honorable judge. This person is a defense lawyer who is trying to defend an accused of a case, and suppose this is a witness who is expert witness for his case, like autopsy doctor who has done autopsy of a dead body. So the doctor has come to courtroom and the public prosecutor examines the doctor first. What is this type of examination of witness called as? Where public prosecutor has the rights to examine that witness to whom he has called to the courtroom. What is this called as? क्या बोलते हैं इसको? What is this called as? Such a witness is called? Such a examination of the witness is called? Direct examination of the witness. The lawyer who has called the witness in the courtroom, he is going to examine the witness. Like autopsy doctor is a prime witness for the public prosecutor case. Usually, so such a examination is called direct examination or examination in chief. Examination in chief. Now in this second image, let us come to second image. Now the public prosecutor is totally okay, normal. Now the defense lawyer becomes very active. And he starts asking some questions to this witness who is a doctor. That what were you all alone in the autopsy room while you were doing autopsy? And it was taken that the witness will answer the question in yes or no. So what is this type of examination called? Kya bolte isko? A very good evening to all of you. So such an examination of the witness now will be called cross examination, where defense lawyer will ask certain questions which are called leading questions, which are allowed usually during cross examination of a witness. And then there is no time limit for this cross examination part. These are the two important points which you should always remember. Now I see that in the third image, what is happening is now this defense lawyer is silent and now the public prosecutor again started examining the doctor to whom he has called to courtroom. after all this finished, direct cross. Now the public prosecutor is again trying to examine the witness, his own witness. What is this examination called? पहले क्या किया था उसने? डायरेक्ट. अब क्या करेगा? रीडायरेक्ट. फिर से डायरेक्ट एग्जामिनेशन को क्या बोलते हैं? रीडायरेक्ट एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ द विटनेस. व्हाई इट इज नीडेड इन सम केसेस? इट इज नॉट डन इन ऑल केसेस. इट इज नीडेड इन दोज केसेस वेयर सम क्लैरिफिकेशन ऑफ द फैक्ट्स ड्यूरिंग क्रॉस एग्जामिनेशन इज मैंडेटरी ऑन व्यू इन व्यूज ऑफ दिस पब्लिक प्रोसिक्यूटर. ही नीड्स टू क्लैरिफाई सम फैक्ट्स लाइक द डॉक्टर अटर्ड फ्यू सेंटेंसेस और वर्ड्स which were contradictory to his earlier statements. So he will clarify those statements. So such an examination will be called redirect examination. Now in this fourth image, both the lawyers are silent. Now the judge is asking some questions from this witness. What are those questions called? Questions asked by judge at any time of judicial proceeding. Questions asked by judge at any time of judicial proceeding. These questions are called, kya bolte inko? This is called court questions. These questions are called court questions. A judge can ask questions from any witness at any time of judicial proceeding. So those questions are court questions. So what all we have covered? We have covered recording of evidence of a witness, which comes as a short notes in second year MBBS. Recording of evidence of a witness consists of these three important parts, or I can say examination of the witness, a very important topic for PG-FMG exams as well as second year MBBS exams. Recording of evidence of the witness, or I can say examination of the witness. So this image finishes this very important topic. Come to second image. Kya dikh raha hai yahan par? What is this first incision telling you? This image is showing me autopsy incisions used to open a dead body. So what are the important autopsy incisions? Like in this image number one, pointer number one is showing you which type of incision. So there should be no confusion in this. This is your modified Y incision, not Y, modified Y, wrongly given at some places. Then what is this second one showing you? This is showing you Y shape incision. So modified Y kahan se shuru hota hai? It can start either from angle of mandible or from your mastoid region behind the ears. Then we reach supra-sternal notch, SS notch, and then we go vertically till pubis symphysis in the midline. So such an incision is modified by Y. Kya hota hai? We start from acromion process, shoulder tip on both the sides. We reach till xiphoid process and then we go vertically till pubis. This is your Y shape. And ideally this Y shape goes inframammary. It goes inframammary. Then this third symbol is pointing towards I-shape incision, which extends from suprasternal notch till your pubis symphysis. So this is your I-shape incision, a straight line. Question of your exams is, which is the most commonly used autopsy incision? Answer goes with this one. Most commonly used for autopsy is I-shape. ठीक है. अब इससे एसोसिएटेड क्वेश्चंस क्या क्या पूछते हैं? मॉडिफाइड वाई इंसिजन विल बी यूज्ड फॉर विच टाइप्स ऑफ डेथ्स? बेसिकली वेयर एवर यू नीड एक्सेलेंट नेक एक्सपोजर. सो यस, इट विल बी यूज्ड फॉर एस्फिक्शियल डेथ्स. दिस वाई शेप इंसिजन इज मेनली यूज्ड इन फीमेल डेड बॉडीज. व्हाई? बिकॉज वी गो इंफ्रा मेमोरी यूजुअली. So the cosmetic integrity of the female is maintained. When the body will be re-stitched, the cosmetic integrity will be maintained. Now there is one more incision, that is inverted Y. So there we start from suprasternal notch, we go till above umbilicus, and then we move laterally to both ASIS. So it becomes inverted Y. This is your fourth incision, inverted Y-shaped incision. In which cases it is used? It is utilized in fetal autopsies. Fetal autopsies. So these are your four important autopsy incisions. Now I will tell you the story of this case. This person came to casualty with injuries over, you can see, right arm and injuries over right side of chest. From a distance, the injuries were appearing as if they are individual pellet wounds. This is the first impression which comes by seeing so many injuries, individual pellet wounds. So you will tell me answer to one question. If I send this person for X-ray, on X-ray, will I get radio opacities over this body part? If I do X-ray of your right arm and right side chest or whole chest, will I get radio opacities located over these body regions? Suppose I do AP and lateral both. Will I get radio opacities? Should I get? Yes or no? Leading question. If you suspect these injuries to be individual pellet wounds, so that you have made that, yes, the person has been fired by a shotgun, will you get radio opacities on X-ray? Radio opacities on X-ray. Yes or no? So here radio opacities were not found, but the margins of the wound were appearing as if they are burnt. The margins were appearing as if they are burnt. So what could be the probable cause of such injuries? So when this person was given tea and coffee, so he told that yes, he has used heated needle. Big size needles are there, na? जिनसे बोरी वगैरह को सिलते हैं. सो हीटेड नीडल वॉज यूज टू प्रोड्यूस इंजरीज बाय हिमसेल्फ. नाउ लीगली स्पीकिंग, हैज ही कमिटेड एनी ऑफेंस इन लॉ? लाइक ही हैज यूज्ड हीटेड नीडल्स टू प्रोड्यूस इंजरीज एज इफ दे विल सिमुलेट इंडिविजुअल पेलेट वाउंड, बट ही वॉज कॉट ऑन एक्सरे. सो हैज ही कॉज्ड एनी ऑफेंस इन लॉ? हैज ही डन एनी ऑफेंस टू हिमसेल्फ by fabricating of false evidence? This is a very good image of your fabricating of false evidence. False evidence like gunshot injury has been done by neighbor, but actually the injury was done by the person himself. So this is a very good example of fabricating false evidence. So this is defined in 192 IPC that this is offense, and punishment to this fellow will be given as per 193 IPC provisions itself. What is the maximum punishment? Maximum punishment in 193 prescribed is up to 7 years, 7 saal. Ha. See, the person came with a history that gunshot was done by the neighbor due to some parking issues. But later on it was found that it was not a case of gunshot because there were no radio opacities, there were no pellet wounds. So when the injuries were examined with hand lens, it was found that the injuries were round but the margins were burnt. So the actual cause was the weapon used was a heated needle to produce all the injuries. Got it? So this will help you to recall what is fabricating false evidence. चलो आगे बढ़ते हैं. कम टू दिस वन. नाउ इफ आई पुट अ एरो ओवर दिस एरिया एंड आई आस्क यू एंड आई गिव यू फोर ऑप्शंस, द केस इज EDH, SDH, SAH और इंट्रा सेरेब्रल हेमरेज. व्हाट यू विल मार्क एज द आंसर ऑफ चॉइस आउट ऑफ ABCD? दिस इज योर ABCD. व्हाट यू विल मार्क एज आंसर ऑफ चॉइस? The arrow is over here. All these are hemorrhages. Got it? So this is your very good image of intracerebral, or I can say intraparenchymal. Intracerebral hemorrhages are also called intraparenchymal. Intraparenchymal. Most common cause of such bleeds are, most common cause of such a bleed is intracerebral, means inside brain matter. Intra means inside. So where? Inside cerebral matter or inside brain parenchyma. So most common of which is, iska most common cause trauma nahi hai. Trauma is the most common cause of SH, preferred over perianeurysmal rupture. These are two important causes of your SH cases. Yahan pe most common cause is hypertension. Most common site which is usually involved is which part of basal ganglia is most commonly involved? Basal ganglia has many parts, no? Globus, pallidus, substantia nigra, subthalamic nucleus. Which part of basal ganglia? Putamen. Putamen part of basal ganglia is the most common site. Other sites can also be involved. This is most commonly involved. Putamen of basal ganglia. Which is the artery which is most commonly involved in hypertensive bleed? Both easy hai. Which is the artery which is supplying this area, all this area? That is the question. Middle cerebral artery, and the most common branch of this artery which is involved in causing your hypertensive bleeds is Charcot's artery, the lenticulostriate branch called as Charcot's artery. All of you know that. Very good. Chalo, to ye, these type of images should be marked correctly. Now, if I show you this image and I ask you, is this injury abrasion, bruise or laceration? What you will mark? A, B or L mein se kya sahi hoga? This is the complete injury. Image is highly magnified. Socho, what you will call such a injury as? Abrasion, bruise or laceration? Simple question. In abrasions, what should happen? There should be a damage of epidermis. In bruises, how do you define bruises? Rupture of soft tissue blood vessel with intact epidermis. So basically you have to make out whether any damage of epidermis is there or not. So, correct answer to this question is bruises. This is how bruises look like. There is no damage of epidermis as such. And what are these bruises called? Where you see two lines of bruises with intervening normal skin. You can appreciate the normal skin area. What are these bruises called? Tram track bruise. So, this is a very good image of your tram track bruise in a living person. The person came in casualty with such bruises. So, tram track bruises are two lines of bruises with intervening normal skin, usually produced by rods, weapons like rods can be iron rod or wooden rod or your lathi. If the injury is a scratch abrasion, you must be confusing this with a scratch abrasion. See, scratch abrasions, there will be damage of epidermis. There will be a red wheel-like thing. But here, if you watch it closely, the epidermis is totally smooth. Mainly over this area, you can appreciate. The epidermis is totally smooth. Nothing has happened to epidermis as such. So, such injuries are bruises. Scratch abrasions will be abrasions where there will be damage of epidermis. Okay? Now, if I show you this image, and I ask you, what will be the range of shotgun to produce such an injury? Range of shotgun. This is the first question. Second question will be, this injury is called as, what do you call this? Complete details of the injury of this. This is a shotgun injury that I have told you. I am asking you the range of the shotgun and what is this injury called as in total. Very good, Soumya. This is your Maltese cross appearance, Maltese cross abrasion, also called as X-shape abrasion, surrounding a irregular shape entry wound. You are getting X-shape abrasion like this. So this is your Maltese cross abrasion and this irregular entry is called rat hole. So whenever you get a rat hole entry with Maltese cross abrasion or X-shape abrasion, what will be the range of shotgun now? So what has happened? Dispersion of pellets started. When the pellets hit the body, the pellets were in dispersion because the range was little bit higher other than contact. Contact mein aisa nahi hoga. Contact mein it will be star shape. This is injury is not a star shape like this. It is not a bursted type of injury. This is irregular entry with abrasions surrounding the main injury. So this is your central rat hole surrounded by Maltese cross abrasion. So the range of the shotgun comes out to be, always remember, yes, very good Arun, 3200 cm. Isme bhi agar specify kare exactly, to at about 50 to 60, what happens is the deformed wad, wad is present in shotgun cartridges. So that wad will also come out along with the lead pellets which are in a shotgun cartridge. So this deformed wad produces a impact over a skin surface because abrasions are blunt injuries. Unless something blunt is being hitting our skin, abrasions won't be produced. So the cause of these abrasions are impact by deformed wad, usually seen at this distance, 50 to 60 centimeter with a shotgun. Okay. For a shotgun, agar conventionally bole, what is this range called as? So up to 30 it is close shot. After 30 the range becomes intermediate shot or near shot or medium range shot. Correct, Tohit? Correct. Chalo, ye ho gaya. Ab answer karo iska. Now in this shotgun wound, I am seeing a central injury surrounding some multiple small injuries. So first question is, what is the range of the shotgun in terms of contact, close, intermediate and distant? Which answer you will mark? Second question will be, what is this injury called as? What do you call such shotgun injuries? पहले का आंसर बताओ, व्हाट विल बी द रेंज ऑफ द शॉटगन? व्हाट विल बी द रेंज ऑफ द शॉटगन? कॉन्टैक्ट, क्लोज, हाँ, वेरी गुड रवि. सो दिस इंजरी विल बी लेबल्ड एज अ रैट होल with satellite wounds. Satellite means central wound ke surrounding mein chote chote pellet wounds because of increased dispersion of the pellets. So obviously this will occur in distant shot. So distant will be your best answer. Nahin, close nahi hoga na. Close mein to all the pellets, see, let us discuss this just a minute. Now, in contact shot, if you have used a shotgun, what will happen? All the pellets, they go inside the body along with the flame, smoke and particles effect, and they produce a stellate shape wound. This is one shotgun entry. In close shot, what happens is all the pellets still they move together and they make a oval entry. Always remember, oval entry. In intermediate shot, what happens? Now the dispersion of pellets start. And now you get an irregular entry called as rat hole. In distant shot, which has been classified at different distances, like if the distant shot is more than 200 centimeter to 400 centimeter, further dispersion of pellets will occur because the distance between weapon and target has increased. So the rat hole will go on becoming smaller as you increase the distance after 200, and this will be surrounded by satellite wounds. So that was the image which was shown to you. If you increase the distance to more than 400 centimeter, distance between shotgun and target, now you will get individual pellet wounds. Individual pellet wounds. Correct? I hope no one will make a error in this area. Shotgun entry size is variable because the projectile used in shotgun cartridges are pellets. It is not a bullet as used in rifled cartridge. Chote chote charre hai. तो जैसे जैसे डिस्टेंस बढ़ेगा ये छर्रों का डिस्पर्शन बढ़ता है. ओके, सो रेंज विल बी डिस्टेंट शॉट एंड सच ए इंजरी विल बी कॉल्ड. अब मान लो ये सेंट्रल रैट होल नहीं है, नाउ यू आर सीइंग ओनली दिस पिक्चर. सो अगेन फॉर मी दिस विल बी डिस्टेंट शॉट एंड स्ट्रिक्टली स्पीकिंग हाउ मच डिस्टेंस, तो मोर देन 400 सेंटीमीटर. ठीक है, नाउ दिस वन विल बी अ रियल टेस्ट. नाउ दिस पर्सन केम फॉर ऑटोप्सी. ड्यूरिंग ऑटोप्सी व्हाट आई सॉ वाज देयर आर मल्टीपल स्मॉल स्मॉल अब्रेशंस. ऑल दीज आर अब्रेशंस. डैमेज ऑफ एपिडर्मिस हैज अकर्ड. देन आई सॉ सम लैसरेटेड वूंड्स आल्सो. दीज आर योर LWs, लैसरेटेड वूंड्स over here also, and these are your abrasions, small small abrasions. Then the whole area was showing me contusion also, like this area is showing me bruising, and bruises were also present. So basically this person had abrasions, bruises and lacerations. Corresponds with which scenario? Like this image corresponds to which type of injuries? What comes to your mind when you see this image? How such an injury will be produced? Multiple mechanisms can be there. Let me hear your thoughts. Wow, very good. Very good, Kusum, Karthik. Perfect. So, this is a very good case of your bomb blast injury, where we have a triad of abrasions, bruises and lacerations. What is that triad called? Marshall's triad. So this is a very good image showing you Marshall's triad completion. Now my second question will be, now your bomb blast injuries are classified into primary, secondary, tertiary and quaternary. Which types of bomb blast injuries present with flying missile injuries? So all these abrasions, bruises and lacerations, they are highly suggestive of flying missile injuries or flying objects acting as missiles and producing injuries over the body. So out of 1, 2, 3, 4, primary, secondary, tertiary, quaternary, which type of bomb blast explosion presents with flying missiles injuries? Out of primary, secondary, tertiary and quaternary, which bomb blast injury will present with flying missiles injury? Yaad karo. So ek baar isko revise kar lete, theek hai? Let us revise this. Our bomb blast explosions are of four types: primary, secondary, tertiary, quaternary. Primary बॉम्ब ब्लास्ट एक्सप्लोजन इंजरीज आर ड्यू टू द इनिशियल शॉक वेव. जब भी एक्सप्लोजन होगा तो एक शॉक वेव प्रोड्यूस होगा ऑफ हाई इंटेंसिटी. सो ऑल द इंजरीज प्रोड्यूस ड्यू टू द इनिशियल शॉक वेव विल बी लेबल्ड एज प्राइमरी इंपैक्ट इंजरीज. सेकेंडरी इंपैक्ट इंजरीज आर ड्यू टू फ्लाइंग ऑब्जेक्ट्स. ऑल द ऑब्जेक्ट्स इन द बॉम्ब ब्लास्ट विसिनिटी जो भी बॉम्ब ब्लास्ट एक्सप्लोजन वाले एरिया में थे, सो ऑल द ऑब्जेक्ट्स नाउ विल एक्ट एज flying missiles. And this is a very good image of flying missiles injury producing abrasions, bruises and lacerations. And this is the most dangerous type of bomb blast explosion injuries. Most dangerous. A repeat question of your All India exams. Which bomb blast injury is most dangerous? Because see, flying missiles can penetrate your vital organs like heart, lung and can kill the person instantly. Now, tertiary bomb blast injuries occurs due to a negative blast wind in the epicenter of bomb explosion, जहां से bomb shock wave शुरू हुआ. In the center, now what happens is there comes out to be a negative wind sort of thing. So, due to this negative blast wind, collisions occur between people or the persons with their surrounding subjects or the wall of the building. People are collided to different things. So all the collisional injuries will be classified as tertiary bomb blast injuries. Then fall of building can also occur and can kill the person. So fall of the building can lead to which type of asphyxial deaths? If the building falls over chest, the person won't be able to respire. Yes, Phoenix, secondary is the answer. So, fall of building will lead to which type of asphyxial deaths? Anyone? Socho. The definition is external compression of the chest is a type of asphyxial death called as traumatic asphyxia. Traumatic asphyxia. क्वार्टरनरी किसको बोलते हैं? क्वार्टरनरी इज ड्यू टू द कॉम्प्लिकेशंस ऑफ द एक्सप्लोजन. कॉम्प्लिकेशंस लाइक फ्लेम बर्न्स हैव अकर्ड ड्यू टू बॉम्ब एक्सप्लोजन. फ्लेम्स हैव बीन प्रोड्यूस्ड. सो फ्लेम बर्न इंजरीज विल बी लेबल्ड एज क्वार्टरनरी बॉम्ब ब्लास्ट इंजरीज. ठीक है, सो दिस इज योर सिंपल क्लासिफिकेशन. सो यू कैन गेट अ क्वेश्चन लाइक दिस ऑल्सो बिकॉज दे हैव आस्क्ड क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम मार्शल स्ट्राइड. नाउ यू विल गेट क्वेश्चंस लाइक दिस एंड द क्लिंचिंग लाइन विल बी देयर that flying missiles have produced such injuries. You will classify this as secondary bomb blast injury. So that's all for today in this session. So regarding upcoming special classes on 8th and 9th, we will have two sessions each of 1 hour duration, where I will be covering all the frequently asked questions in second prof exams. And these frequently asked questions are important questions of your PG and FMG exams also. So you all also can attend, those who are preparing for their PG exams. The exact timing and the link of the course I will be sharing, most likely by today or by tomorrow. So these will be free live sessions on 8th and 9th of February. And regarding YouTube sessions, you can find me on YouTube on every Monday and Thursday, same time. Like today is a Thursday, my next session will be on Monday, same timing, 4:30 to 5 p.m. for February month. So these sessions on 8th and 9th, actually these have been kept keeping in view the request by the students themselves. So those who are preparing for PG or FMG entrance, they can also, because theoretical revision will be done of all the frequently asked question topics. Okay. चलो बाय बाय, थैंक यू एवरीवन, एंड डू अटेंड योर अन अकेडमी कॉम्बैट ऑन 7th of Feb at 5 PM, and you can use the code this one to unlock an academy combat. There you will be asked a invite code, so you can put this code. Chalo, bye bye, bye bye. Keep smiling, all of you. Smile is very good thing. You should always keep smiling, whatever may be the scenario you are facing in life. If you have a smile on your face, your worries are lessened. Chalo, bye bye, bye bye.